drive system that comes out COT, and it's drive speed, which is RPMs. Here's our steady state operating curve. It's pretty linear, actually very linear, and it's separated into four parts for each team member. And then the step function is shown here. And for the step function, and then it goes into the transfer function, which comes out in speed RPMs. Here is the transfer function. I have here our values for our gain put in to have the number values in there. It's about 17 for the gain, -0.1 for the dead time, and 0.2 for the tau. Here is a step response, FOPDT model analysis. It's from 95% to 5%, and the red and the blue with the circle, that's the model output and input, so you can see on there. And then the experimental output and experimental input is these lines here. And the step down, they vary a little bit. The step up, they're closer, but I'm using Trevor's just as an example for y'all to see. Here is our step response dead time values. They're all about the same. I've got 0.1. Just varying from 0.08 to 0.1, and it's the green is up and the gray is down for each section that we split. Here is the time constants doing the same thing. They just vary from about 0.23 to 0.3. And here's the up values and the down again. Here's the gain values. It looks like they change a lot, but it's not really that much. It's about 16.8 up to about 17.7, and the green is up and the gray is down. Here is the actual data with the uncertainties calculated for each of our members, and the tau is 0.25 plus or minus 0.048 seconds for the up. The dead time is 0.096 plus or minus 0.009 seconds. And then the gain is 17.2 plus or minus 0.42 RPMs per percent. And then for the step down, it's the tau is 2.6 plus or minus 0.042 seconds. And the dead time is 0.095 plus or minus 0.012 seconds. And then for K, it's 17.3 plus or minus 0.45 RPMs per percent. Here is a sine experiment for the Bode plot, and it's at a frequency of 0.2 hertz. And as you can see here, if a period is from the top of the loop to the next loop, that's 1.643 seconds. And then the offset, there's three of them here for calculus uncertainties, and it's 0.112, 0.132, and 0.128. And the delta C is this line here, the light blue line. It's 363.81, 367.31, and 367.14. And remember, the blue is the input values and the red is the output values. And this is the transfer function. It's a sine function. Goes into the system and it comes out in RPM. Here is the Zhu figure for the Bode plot. And it's at 0.2 hertz, and the output is in RPM versus percent. So the delta M is the top. It's 23.998%, and the delta C is 366.0853 RPM. And they're so exact because I used the max value minus the min value for the given range by just looking and seeing which points I needed to use to just get them more exact. Here's the sine experiments for Bode plot, the data to make the Bode plot. Here's the frequencies I used, the amplitude ratio, and then the amplitude ratio uncertainties, to notice they're very small, like about zero. The phase angle, going from negative to even smaller negative value, and the phase angle uncertainties, and then the phase angle model, beta. And I'll show you the formula I used to get that later. Here's the Bode plot. This is the top part of it, so that you can see, and it's frequency versus amplitude ratio, and they're both in log to log, and then the K is 17.9 RPM per cent, RPM per cent, is that okay? And the FU is 2.4 cycles per time, which is in seconds, and that line, I'll show you how it's median at 100, negative 180 phase angle. And then the 1 over KCU is 3.19 RPM per percent, and that's where that line crosses our Bode curve. And then the point A right here is what I use to find the tau and the dead time. And the blue line there is the order, it's the negative of the slope, so it's about 1. And as I was talking about before, there's that line that goes down to negative 180. And the light pink line is the phase angle model. And then the dark, the red line, is the phase angle experimental data. And the black you see there are so small, it's the uncertainties. But they're there. You just have to look, they're tiny. For the Bode plot results, they're all about the same, about 17.9 in the lower region, middle region, and upper region. The dead time, lower region, middle region, upper region, just changes from about 0.21 to 0.25. Then the time constants is 0.21 for the lower region up to 0.23 for the middle and upper region. It's really not that much of a difference, but the scale makes it look much more than what it is. Here's the data found from the Sine model. The tau is 0.163 seconds. The gain, K, is 0.313 RPM per percent. The dead time is 0.25 seconds. The order is about 1 for thirst. And the FU is 2.4 cycles per second. KCU is 1 over 3.19, which is, what is the KCU? And illustrations of the experiments and model for three different frequencies, the low, medium, and high, are shown here. The low frequencies, you can see here, these are U, so about linear. Medium, just getting more round, the curves are seen easier. And then here's for the high frequency, where it's really almost about flat. And then two of our members, Trevor and Dan, they had to do an alternate relay. And this is one of the set points for Daniels. And the green line is the input value percent, and the gray curves is output in RPM, and the orange right there is the set point in RPM. And now for all of our data together, the normal and alternate relay, the FU values, the this one, and this one is for the Sine, which was used for the Bode, and then this one and this one is the alternate values. And they vary quite a bit, but that's what our values are. And then for the KCU, again, this line and this line is Andy's and mine, and they're much greater than the values for Daniel's and Trevor's, which are those two lines. And then in conclusion, the AR equation is used to find the tau, which is 0.163 seconds. Then the phase angle equation, as you see here, is used to find the dead time, which is 0.25 seconds. And the gain is 17.9 RPM per percent. And the FU is 2.26 plus or minus 0.816 hertz. And the KCU equals 0.238 plus or minus 0.0918 per percent for RPM.